Hi everyone, and welcome to another open scene. Today we're going to talk about this bedroom. I've made it, I don't know, maybe 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. I can't remember it very well. But a lot of people asked me about how I made this lighting. So I decided to record a video to explain three little tricks I used in this scene. Okay, so let's go. Okay, so before I start talking about the three tricks, I will show you a little bit of the scene. It's a very small scene. I usually work with small scenes because it's easier to control lighting and also to prop the scene. But of course, if the client needs a bigger scene or entire apartment, entire house, definitely we have to do that. So, but when I do images for my Instagram, my Facebook, I usually try to work with small scenes because it's easier. Okay, so let's take a look on the render. And also, I'm going to show you the HDRI that I'm using in this scene. So it's a overcast HDRI. Actually, it's not a completely overcast because you can see that there is a sun coming from the clouds. So it's happening. It's actually helping to cast this lighting on the side of the pillow. Okay. So another thing that I think it's important when it comes to lighting is, and especially HDRI, is that I see that a lot of people, they don't rotate the HDRI, and it's very important if you want to achieve any specific mood, because when you import an HDRI, you have only one scenario, and this scenario is the 0x. So you must explore the HDRI, you must to see other kind of sides, or other kind of angles that sometimes can improve your image. Okay, so it's very important you play with the transforms and see other possibilities. Okay, to your image. So this is one thing that's very important. Okay, so let's go to the first trick of this scene. The first thing we're going to talk about is this background. As you see, I'm not using a background in Photoshop, so I decided to use a background in the 3D, but this background is not casting shadows. And as you can see, if I move it up, the entire lighting remains the same. The lighting didn't change. Okay, so where I set this up, you have to go to the object properties and then go to the octane settings and shadow visibility. Okay, so the next trick is about this light plane, this plane light actually. And this plane light is helping to enhance the lighting coming from the sun. So that's the reason I use this light plane light in this specific scene. I usually don't use any other light source, but in this case I needed to enhance some highlights from the sun and bring some more white to the scene. Okay, so that's the reason I use it. So this guy is set to transparent emission and the opacity, as you can see, 0, and power 145. But if I increase it, you can see that it's much more exaggerated. So the reason I'm using like a low number here is because I just wanted like some more highlights and more fuel light as well. And the last trick about this scene is this floor plane around my scene. You can see that this plane is casting shadows to my ceiling. Okay, so that's the reason I use it. And I use it actually very often because it brings more realism to the scene. And also I can control the lighting coming from the ground. So this is something that's very important, having control of your lighting. And in this case, I have full control of my sailing lighting because I'm controlling it by my plane ground, okay? So what's happening here? The sun or the sky is bouncing lighting on my plane light, on my plane ground. And this plane is bouncing lighting back to my scene, okay? So this is very cool. I show you another trick is if I have this plane, I have a material to apply to it. So if I want less lighting coming from outside, the only thing I need to do is decrease the albedo. So again, I have full control, like this, I have full control of my sailing and also my entire scene, because I'm not just talking about sailing, because the sailing is just one part. The sailing is also bouncing the lighting from the rest of the scene. So this is a really nice trick, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and see you in the next video. Thank you very much.